So I am Dave Motke, producer for The Sims Studio.
And I'm Graham Nardone, another producer at The Sims Studio.
Awesome. And it is our pleasure to get to show to you guys The Sims 4 Get to Work, which is the first expansion pack to The Sims 4. We're offering three new active playable careers, including the doctor, the detective, and the scientist. Oh, no.
It's scenic,
Graham,
man. Stop. Gotta take a shot.
Three new active careers, as well as the ability to own and operate your own retail business, as well as some really cool little goodies that we have hidden inside. So as part of the theme of this pack, active careers, in these three new careers, when it's time to go to work, your Sims can actively go to these lots. So each of our new careers does have a new venue that comes with it. This is the scientist, this is Future Sim Labs. One of the existing neighborhoods, but definitely tried to retrofit it with an Area 51 kind of feel and flair. Is our scientist feeling a little hungry right now?
A little peckish this morning. I'm gonna grab a snack.
Yeah, we didn't get breakfast on the way to work. So we're up at one of the top levels of the science lab. Here we can actually see a little bit more in terms of new objects and new decoratives. So an average day in the life of the scientist is gonna find them working with their coworkers to explore and discover new fauna, gems, new materials like that. They'll also be working on science-related activities like the rocket ship and the telescope in order to have breakthroughs. These breakthroughs in turn lead to new inventions and new things for the scientist to create. So Graham, let's not worry about his food. Let's go downstairs and have a little fun in the science
lab. I'm just going to let that thing get nuked in there, though.
It's fine. Just leave it in there. We can clean it out later. So if we go down, So in our science lab, we have a couple of cool new signature objects. We can see our coworkers are busy working right now for science. We are a high-level scientist, hence the really cool techie-type outfit that he has and eye goggles. So right now, Graham is moving on over to the chemistry lab. Here, we're going to experiment, tinker, make new serums. The serums are really neat. There's a whole bunch of different serums that you can create, that you can give to yourself or other Sims that has a host of in-game ramifications. There's this push big red button.
What do you think?
I don't think you should do that. I don't think so. Let's not
experiment
do that.
This morning?
You can do a little experiment, or you know what? Even better than that, if you open up your inventory, you'll find our scientist has actually been working on a few new inventions. One of those on the far right there is the SimRay. SimRay's a really neat object that the scientist can create that will allow you to freeze Sims, transform objects, even control their minds. In fact, maybe let's play a little prank on our coworker.
Who do we have over here? This is Brielle Danielson.
Brielle Danielson. So let's click on Brienne. So we can do a little mind control. Maybe let's change her outfit.
What do you think?
Maybe put her in some jammies.
Sure.
Perfect shots.
Ooh, what's happening?
She seems okay. Is it working? Hey, okay. That's nice. I don't think she's noticed yet, which is a good thing.
We'll get out of here before there's any trouble.
Good. Why don't you move on over to the invention constructor? And let's go ahead and tinker on that. So the invention constructor, or IC, is probably my favorite object on the scientist lot. Really cool little robot that you can actually become friends with. He's going to help you form these new inventions. This is kind of like a cross between a 3D printer and a highly functioning AI, kind of like Jarvis from Iron Man.
Should we actually start making one this morning?
Let's actually start making one.
Yeah. Let's invent a device. What are you thinking?
Let's try a hover lamp. I'm always interested in a cool little lava lamp for my science lot.
I love the way this thing actually kind of brings the objects to life. It's kind of fun seeing them as they get built and constructed. We'll see if he actually starts printing one here for us. There we go.
So again, as the scientist kind of ramps up on their skills and has breakthroughs, more and more invention recipes, for lack of a better term, will be unlocked to the player. Again, most of these inventions can be carried back home, so you can find some really cool, kind of crazy ways to use this, even outside of your profession.
Now, something I thought was really cool that our scientists made recently was an interesting-looking portal. I saw it on the way walking into the building this morning.
Yes, it's the Electroflux Wormhole Generator. He's actually been working on that for a while. If you look over, I think we placed it in the hallway.
There it is.
Yeah, that's a very interesting device. We might use it in a second. But before that, actually, open up your inventory again, Graham.
Okay.
And why don't you pull out the cloning machine?
Hmm.
So the cloning machine is a pretty interesting object. It is a cloning machine, pretty much what you would expect. And clicking on it will reveal that you can either clone objects or clone Sims. So let's go ahead and clone our Sim.
Ooh, you're in the trouble this morning.
That's right. I want to make sure that we can do good at work without having to do the work ourselves, you know what I mean? So cloning Sims is really fun. It does make a copy of whatever Sim you send onto the machine. However, there is a chance of failure. And failure with clones is exactly what you'd expect. It generates an evil clone of your Sim. So you'll see red eyes. Our guy happens to have goatees right now, but if you had a clean-shaven Sim step up and get cloned and he was evil, he's gonna have that evil goatee.
I think the takeaway here is they're probably both evil.
They seem fine. In fact, they're
good
friends.
Buddies.
They're good buddies. So we can probably leave this guy at work now and have him carry on the day while we go out and have a little fun. Yep, it's a perfect clone. So why don't we go ahead and check out that wormhole generator that you were talking about earlier?
Now, I don't know, this thing looks a little sketchy, Dave. Safe?
I'm sure we've calibrated it right. Let's go ahead and travel, see what happens. What's the worst that could happen, right?
Lose a limb or two, I'm sure it's fine.
Just a limb, we could grow those back. So we're gonna pop through this portal and actually see where it takes us. So again, each of the new careers has kind of a new cool place to go to, new cool uniforms that you'll get to wear to work, that you'll get to unlock and use to cast your Sim out, a host of new objects. You'll probably hear me say this 1,000 times, but I am amazed with the amount of content that we've been able to pack into this EP. And it looks like, where have we actually arrived, Graham?
Looks like the planet Sixum.
The planet Sixum. So, okay, well, I guess this is as good a chance now as ever to talk about aliens. So, aliens is a race of creature that we have brought back into The Sims. But there's a couple of new differences. First off, the things that you might be familiar with, can aliens steal you in the middle of the night?
They can. Abductions are still
a thing,
of course.
Abductions are still a thing. Do males get abducted?
Absolutely. And
what could happen if a male gets abducted?
Maybe a male pregnancy.
Pregnancy, that's right. So males can get pregnant through alien abductions, and for the first time ever, you can actually send them to the hospital to give birth. Another new thing that we've done with aliens in The Sims 4 Get to Work is, as you can see here, you can travel to the alien homeworld. This is the first, and it quite a beautiful homeworld it is. We seem to have caught our aliens in some sort of bizarre dance party. I don't know exactly what they're doing, but they seem friendly enough.
I just figured I'd grab a drink. I mean, seems like the right thing to do.
Hey, when in Rome or when in Sixum. The other new thing that I'm extremely excited about with aliens is the ability for them to wear human disguises. So you probably have aliens walking around in your neighborhood right now and you don't even know it. You can actually take your aliens into CAS and design little skin suits for them. So you can take them and have them actually have a human form, which can then be revealed at any time, or you can discover if a Sim is an alien. You can actually make aliens yourselves right out of CAS. We don't have an alien this time around to do the big reveal. But that's okay. If we were an alien right now wearing a skin suit, we could actually click on ourselves and change into our alien form. But it turns out that our scientist is a human, who it looks like needs to go to the bathroom pretty badly.
Yeah, do you know if they have toilets on Planet Sixum?
He'll find out one way or the other. Hey, while we're here, let's see if we can make an alien mad. Why don't you go ahead and try to freeze one of them?
Here's one right here.
So again, that sim ray can be used in a variety of different ways. This way is the always fun little prank to freeze a sim. I kind of feel bad, like if you leave them, they'll eventually kind of melt and go back to living, but I feel bad about leaving them, so why don't we, let's break them out of there.
There we go. Yeah, I don't think we want to be too hostile towards the aliens on their home world. There we go.
All good. So that's kind of a quick little look at the scientist's career and some of our alien content. I hope you enjoyed a little sneak preview of this. We're going to go ahead and pause it and skip on over to the retail aspect of this demo.
So I'm going to get him off of playing Blip Walk so that we can head down to our store.
Cool.
Which I'm assuming you've opened up in our brand new neighborhood of Magnolia Promenade.
I have opened a new store in Magnolia Promenade, or as I like to call it, Magnolia Promenade. Tomatoes, tomatoes. So in our new neighborhood, we have four new lots. Three of those are pre-built with new retail stores. One of them's an empty lot for you to move right in on. Now that being said, you are completely able to customize those lots as you see fit. You can make retail stores in the existing base game neighborhoods. You can make all four lots retail lots in the new neighborhood. It's really up to you how you want to use that space. Here we've actually set up kind of a bare bones museum type retail store. Grant, why don't you walk us through some of the functionality?
Yeah, so I just kind of wanted to come in and get a lay of the land. This is your store after all. So I clicked on the register and I just selected the toggle for sale tag just to kind of get an idea of what you're selling. So you've got these nice statues I noticed down front. Some pretty jazz art on the wall.
So I see like a lot of art and decorative type stuff being marked for sale. What can you actually sell at your retail store?
Absolutely anything, which is a really nice benefit of it. Now, I see you grabbed a number of things out of kind of our buy catalog. But let's say my sim was an artist himself. He could always grab an easel, you know, maybe take the camera from our new photography skill and take pictures or create paintings and sell those in his store as well.
Cool, so pretty much anything you can buy or make out of the game, you can turn around and sell in your retail store.
Mm-hmm. Now, the first thing I'm gonna do here is just go ahead and open up for business. We've got a few things for sale. I've got my price markup at 25% today, which I feel pretty comfortable with. And we'll see if we can get some workers in here as well, maybe. We can do that by managing our employees. I see you've already hired Donna. Looks like we have some aliens we could hire today
as well. We just met them. We got to put them to work.
It's true. So the kind of the way it works in here is you'll get different sims throughout the neighborhood who you can hire. Just so happened that I randomly got a bunch of aliens today, but that'll change as you go back and check it as well. So I believe we have some customers heading our way.
So what kind of themes can you put on your retail store, Graham? Is this like kind of specific? Did you specifically make this a museum or?
Oh, it's absolutely anything. We set this one up as kind of an art gallery, but whatever you want to do, you could do woodworking, sell your crafted furniture and sculptures. I really like doing the bear store. I was tweeting about this the other day, but taking our new mannequins, dressing them up as bears, and then selling those outfits back to unsuspecting Sims in the neighborhood.
Well, let's see, I know we kind of have an art theme going right now. Do you want to buy an existing NPC store, or maybe you just want to put a mannequin down in here?
Yeah, why don't we plop a mannequin down? You know, this place is kind of artsy-fartsy. I think we could find a nice use for it.
But you know what, Graham? I don't think we should put a mannequin up here. I think it looks too nice. It's too much of a kind of modern museum feel to it.
Okay.
Maybe we can put it downstairs.
Ooh, I like that idea. Looks like we've got some room here.
Oh, we've got nothing but room. Let's do it.
Why don't I pop in the build mode then?
Sweet, and let's put in some basements. So yes, that is right. Basements have returned. Basements are actually a feature that we are giving away for free. Very close to the release of this expansion pack. Sims can now build two levels down, and we've also added one story at the top. So in base game, you could actually build a 3-level house. You can now build a 4-level house and 2 levels of basement for a total of 6 stories that you can put on your lots. I am a simple producer, so you might want to check my math, but I'm pretty sure we've doubled the size of the buildings that are allowed. Some really cool features that we've also made with basements is the ability for them to auto-connect to foundations, so you don't have to micromanage the foundations of your house in order to plop these basements in, as well as open air ceilings on basements. So we can actually make basements where we remove the floor on top, and you'll actually see like a really cool like hole from the top floor looking down. This is really useful in making buildings that you want to have kind of an open air stairwell, or even 2 basement floors that aren't right on top of each other. You can use really interesting kind of corkscrew layouts and designs.
All right, so awesome. We'll get some mannequins in here. We can even select some different colors for them. We'll go for red to match our back wall there. Get some children mannequins in here because we support all different types. And then we can start customizing these even. So I will bring my employee down here and we'll start getting some styles put together.
Awesome. So as Graham was saying, we don't really limit you to any theme. You can make a retail store as unitasking as you want, or one type of object or service. Or you can really mix and match. I actually like making kind of little strip mall type retail stores where I'm selling a little bit of this, a little bit of that.
And what are you feeling today for an outfit, Dave?
Oh gosh, I don't know. I'm always partial to a little Darth Vader. I'm partial to a little cop action.
Ooh, do we have the bear suit today?
So the bear suit is part of the content for The Sims 4 Outdoor Retreat, and it looks like we do have it installed.
Now we should say the bear suit itself does not come with The Sims 4 Get to Work.
That is part of
Game Pack 1, but you know, we take content from everything that we've released, yeah, and you can use that in your retail stores.
All of the clothing options that are available to you based off of your base game purchase, as well as any packs that you have installed as well, will be available to use on the mannequin.
Now, something that I think is really cool about the mannequins, a lot of people don't immediately notice, is we let you adjust them however you like. So we can totally pump up his muscles, and then we can go in there, you know, give the mannequin a big butt if you want. It's entirely up to you.
How many outfits can you store on a mannequin? Is this the only one?
Mannequins actually have up to 30 outfits on each different type. So the male here that I just created, you can have 30. We can do 30 for each of the kids and the adult female as well. So pretty cool stuff. And of course, if I just want to quickly set up, our scientist is headed home for the day.
Cool. He made some cash. That's good.
But if we just want to quickly set up some additional outfits to sell, we can actually randomize some outfits.
Awesome.
Did I see some? We'll just do that for the rest of them.
Poses in there as well?
Of course you did. So we can choose some fun ones here. Let me just get outfits on everyone. So we can actually do a variety of different poses. So the confident child. Our playful child. He's having fun.
Awesome.
It's kind of preppy. I like that one. Straight out of The Simpsons. let's see, the flirty man. And how about active? There we go. So you can really quickly do a variety of things to kind of set up a unique clothing boutique if you wanted to. Got a lot of alien shopping in our store today. They must really like to gather our artwork.
Well, we introduced our family to them and I think they feel safe with us now.
What do you say we actually go through and kind of complete one sale with our customers here?
Let's do it.
So I'm going to greet, who is this here? Brady Hilton.
So correct me if I'm wrong, Graham. As soon as you open your retail store, based on a variety of factors like what you have for sale, your curb appeal, etc., retail customers will start filtering into the store?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is a variety of things. So kind of depending on the price range that they're interested in, it'll make it easier or more difficult to sell to them if you have items appropriate for what they're looking for. It looks like Callie here is actually slightly more interested in buying. I can kind of tell by the bars over their head. So I'm going to work on selling something to her instead. So we'll ask about her price range, just get a little bit of an idea. And as we go, you can see when I'm interacting with my customers, I'm actually earning these perk points down here as well. I've got 90 of them so far, and each time I chat with somebody or make a sale or help restock the store, I'm earning some more of those. And what they do is they bring up a variety of rewards here that I can go through and purchase. So I can just have enough to afford my first Simoleon placard here, so I'm gonna grab that one. But there's a variety of great ones, so you can use this to start hiring additional employees. You can make your own Sims faster at restocking or checking out other customers. And then some really powerful ones down here. Like, I love Shore Sale because it guarantees my customer's gonna buy. And then powerful stuff like instant restocking and cheaper restocking to really help you kind of churn those profits out.
Cool. So the new careers are rewarding the player with new career objects, new career uniforms, things like that. Whereas the retail system seems a bit more open-ended, where you're earning a currency and then you're choosing what rewards you want to buy for it.
Yeah, it's very much about that kind of classic sandbox gameplay. And we even give you like fine-tuned controls over your current finances. So you can see I'm not doing too great today. I'm down $72, so I better make a sale here.
Nowhere to go but up.
And if I really need to, I can always transfer funds back and forth between my store and my household as well. So I can even bring in a little more money here. I want an additional $5,000.
So as we're actually going through and kind of finalizing the sale, you are... Oh, let's close
I'm confident
it. Close
today.
The
let's
deal.
Try it.
Let's make that Simoleons. So customers kind of come in, they have a finite amount of time they're going to hang out, and it seems like it's up to you as the retail owner or the employee
to
actually go
through. Oh no, she didn't like my strong arm tactics.
Go through and convince them, and you did not convince them, Graham.
Let's see, I can save this. I'm going to have to be a little friendly, butter them up a bit. It's fine.
There's definitely some interesting gameplay presented here. I constantly find myself when I'm playing as a retail owner, constantly asking myself whether or not I want to invest the time trying to upsell one sim and really get a lot of simoleons out of them, or if I want to take a more shotgun scatter approach where I'm investing small amounts of time in customers and just selling them really cheap things real fast.
All right, I'm giving up on Kelly because I happen to notice Romeo back here is actually ready to buy. He's been browsing. He made the purchase decision himself, so let's ring him up here. And a lot of what you were saying goes back to the prices that you set. Let's say I did a 5% markup on my prices. I might not even have to interact with my customers very much. They're going to see the value that I'm offering, and they're going to want to come in and just buy in droves. Now, if I change that to 100% markup, certainly I'm going to make a lot more money per sale, but I'm going to have to really work at convincing each customer.
I love the little personal attention your salesman has given this sim. You walk right up. Is that a little Google action?
Yeah, we're very modern. We check them out on the tablet. So, you know, just swipe through their credit, make sure they're legit. I don't know what they use on Planet Sixum, but as long as I get my money, I'm fine.
Your money is all good here. So, it's not very often you're going to see an alien that's shopping at your retail store. So I think it's kind of important right now, Graham, that we actually capture this moment for posterity.
Ooh, I like that. Should I grab a camera?
Why don't you just use your cell phone?
Okay. Let's see if we can snag him.
Wait, no, come back.
Don't head down the street.
Oh, there's another one.
Wait, what's his name? Romeo. Okay, let's see.
So part of Sims 4 Get to Work brings back the photography system. So photography is a fully expanded 10-level skill, but we've added some very cool modern twists to the photography system. So you have your cell phone that you're carrying around all the time. Interactions on that cell phone are gonna include take a selfie, take a photo of whatever you want, or take photo of specific Sims, take selfies with other Sims, just like we see here.
There you
go. It's beautiful.
Perfect.
Nobody would believe us otherwise. There are a few options that you can do with phones, including changing the aspect ratio of your pictures, so you can do vertical or horizontal, as well as a host of filter options. So let's go ahead and do another picture, and let's apply some Instagram-like filters on it.
There we go. What are you feeling today? Black and white.
Gotta keep it classy. Black and white's always nice.
Oversaturated. Invert.
That's probably the only way to make me look good, so inversion's good.
All right, I like it.
So not only do you have the cell phone to take cameras on, but there's also several camera models that you can buy at a build buy. The better the camera, the better the functionality. You can make small pictures, medium pictures, large pictures, as well as taking
Unfortunately, Dave, I have to point out here, I'm not a very skilled photographer yet.
You're not a very skilled photographer. So you see the little gnome popping in that ruined your picture. It looks like
these
you blurred him out.
That's all right. I'm going to try and sell them anyway.
Cool. So what Graham is showing is that we can actually take pictures, hang them on the wall. We can sell them as retail objects. We can also throw this lot up to the gallery so other people can download it back into their game and see all the creations that we've made.
Oh, these pesky Sims, always dealing with their needs. I'm going to cheat a little more.
Sweet.
Sorry, everyone.
So while we're talking about cameras, maybe go in and put down the photography studio as well. Ooh. And we can show how we can convert this retail store into an art, into a photo gallery with just a couple of clicks.
Let's see. Do-do-do-do-do. I know it's in activities. There it is.
Cool. So along with cameras that allow you to take pictures, we've also included the photography studio object. So this is really handy when you want to take group pictures. You can set plenty of backdrops on it. You can even use the move object cheats to kind of create a nice three-dimensional background.
I like this one the best.
It's so unique.
All right, so let's take a group photo here. Let's get some, all my alien buddies.
So this is just a neat little object that's going to allow you to take some really cool posed shots of some of your favorite Sims. Awesome. As you can see right now, Graham's able to zoom in and out, something he wasn't able to do with his standard cell phone cam. And it looks like he's going to make some large photographs.
Let's see how these ones come out. Hopefully a little bit better than my others. We'll find a little wall space here. There we go. Oh yeah,
hey,
those turned
look
out
a
nicely.
Lot better. So we can set them for sale. We can also put photo frames on it. So if you click on that. Oh,
swap it back here then. Where's our
very
frame?
Top, we can add a frame. We can add effects to it even after we've taken the picture. And
we can go back and actually set those filters later, which is pretty handy.
Yeah, and one super, super helpful interaction that you're gonna find available on all your craftables is the clone option.
I do like this. It's actually coming to everybody. So this is handy, you know, not just for new things like photography, but if you're writing books in the base game or creating paintings, you can actually go make copies of this. So if you do sell it, now you've got another one.
Awesome.
Loses a little bit of value each time, so the first edition of everything is always going to be the best one, but it's great for running a store.
Yeah, retail is just a system that I am so excited for, and I think you pushed really hard on this, Graham. It's a really deep, open-ended system. I think Sims players are just going to have a blast with this. So The Sims 4 Get to Work will be releasing on March 31st, end of this month, at a price point of $39.99, and we will be releasing simultaneously for Windows and Mac.